Hi, Charles Millman here. Well, I just ran some tests on my Iceco Go 20 and the Jackery 160 for a friend of mine, and I'd like to tell you the results. Thanks for watching. So what I did was a series of three tests for a friend of mine who had taken my advice, and she bought one of these Iceco Go 20s. These are great 12-volt refrigerators, and I have video reviews of it that you can look at, so I'm not going to get all detailed, but it's really great. It's 20 liter. It's smaller than maybe some people want, but for my wife and I, it works great. And it has a German-made compressor in it, so it's 5-year warranty, really, really well made. And they make a bunch of different sizes of these products. And then the Jackery's, I've been a fan of those for quite a while. So I own the 160, the 500. I know about the 240, and I haven't gotten a 1000 either, but I can talk about them. And so what I did was some tests using this in three different modes. And but there are variables, and just so I want to up front with that, you have to think about where you normally would run this. So you have to consider the numbers I give you aren't taking into effect. It's a hot day. Where do you have it set? How often did you open it? Do you have it full of food? Which I did. I kept the refrigerator and freezer with appropriate food filled up so it would hold the temperature. So it's, you can't just look at a 160 watt or 500 watt and know that this typically, I noticed around 28 watts, it pulls most of the time when the compressor's running. You can't just do straight math because you have those variables involved. So you have to be aware of that. For example, I have a little fan down here. If you plug that in and know what the, and see what the watts are, you can just divide and you can figure out how long this thing's because it's constantly running. But with a 12-volt refrigerator like this or another brand, it's going off and on, cycling off and on, just like your refrigerator at home. So there are those variables, so I do understand that. So my numbers are kind of close, but at least they give you a rough idea. Okay, test number one, I had the Jackery 160, the Iceco running dual mode, so it's a refrigerator and a freezer, it's got that partition in, full of food. From 100% to zero, it ran for 5.5 hours, okay, 5.5 hours. Test two, I ran the Jackery full 100%, the Iceco set to 35 degrees. Now we're running this as a refrigerator, 35 degrees, all open, filled with food and liquids, and the runtime was 100% down to zero was 14 hours and 40 minutes. Not bad for a little bitty battery like that. And then test number three, I ran it just as a freezer. And so when I did that, I had it set at zero, and I had frozen food and an ice pack or two in there, so it was nice and full. And so from 100% to zero, it ran for 6 hours and 11 minutes. Okay, so that gives you a rough idea. And so for my friend, she's talking about running it as a freezer during travel, and then when she gets to her destination, now it's a refrigerator. 6 hours and 11 minutes, it's going to be close. So we kind of decided that she needed to get at least a 240 because that would be 30% more power. And so I went ahead and did some numbers because I think I can come close now that I have this baseline. Again, it was pulling about 28 watts. So that test one, when I had a freezer and fridge running together, a zero and 35 degrees, the 160, as I've already said, did 5.5 hours. I would say a Jackery 240 would be roughly 7.5. The 500 would be 15 plus hours, and the Jackery 1000 would probably be 30 hours or so running the fridge freezer combo. The test two that I did, remember we had the Jackery 160 ran for 14 hours and 40 minutes just running as a refrigerator at 35 degrees. The 240 would be roughly 18.5 hours. The Jackery 500 would be around 37 plus hours, and the 1000 would be like 74 hours before we get down to zero. Keep in mind, you've got to get that charge back up. And then the last test was running it just as a freezer, and the 160 ran it for a little over six hours. The Jackery 240 would be around 7 hours, the Jackery 500 would be about 14 plus hours, and the 1000 would be around 28 hours. And so, again, they you have to keep in mind the charge time. So people sometimes forget, oh, it can run that for so many hours. But don't forget, you've either got to have a lot of good sun and enough solar panels running, or you're at shore power, or you're driving and charging from the car with the 12-volt plugs while you're traveling. So you have to really know what you're doing, what you're trying to accomplish, and then that will guide you what size battery. I mean, I think the 500 would be great, but if you can get by with the 240 and that's what you can afford, then you get the 240. I think the, as I've mentioned before in my other videos, I think the Jackery 500 is just a perfect solution for the average camper, especially small campers like what I have. So I hope you can maybe transfer some of that information to help you with whatever refrigerator you've got and whatever size of lithium battery that you've got, and just to give you a ballpark figure on what you can run with the refrigerators. And no, I'm not going to run a bunch of tests on other things for you. Sorry, but thanks for watching.